thank you, Dr. Miao. That's a bit of history as well. Now let's go to the future plan, and I'm going to request here Dr. Hei Leung to talk about the future plan for the book.
Okay, I didn't prepare much. I just thinking out loud in some way. So when I heard about this launching, this is, what came to mind is it's extremely timely. So for a long time we've been doing well, I would say up to the 1980s, in terms of controlling diseases, right? But then there's some neglect from IRRI in terms of continuing that investigation of rice diseases. So we're shifting our attention to abiotic stress. So there's a lot of activities, isolating genes for drought tolerance. Some intolerances have a lot of sub-1 gene. So a lot of the emphasis is shifted to what abiotic stresses. So I think climate change is not just about drought, flooding, and so on. It's a lot of impact on the biotic environment. So what it means is that when you neglect the pathogen or insect, they come and haunt you. So I think luckily we're beginning to see the importance of disease and insects affecting rice crop. So we gradually come back to the issue that recently I talked to our Director General. So he told me that we need to rebuild our pathology program. So I was delighted when there's an opportunity for us to launch the disease management, disease biology, and so on, as an e-book. So that's really I think Tom mentioned all the motivation we have, and I think now we come to tuition. About the future plan, I think there's obviously, we really want to maintain the website class standard. Second, we'll update the website with new information, new diseases, and so on. So for instance, false mud is a recent disease. You don't hear about it 2 years ago, but just recently you hear about it. And then around the world, in India, very serious, and then China already taking the lead to work on WASMA. So we are doing some of that. So this is one example how the dynamic of the pathogen populations and changes are happening. So new information we will continue to deposit on the website. And I think we also want to make sure that they're easy to download so anyone can get a computer or even anyway. One click, done, so make it easy. So finally, I'd like to propose we should be more innovative to add in terms of adding information. So it just occurred to me that the concept of phytobiome is coming up. Phytobiome is a form of pathology, if you think about it. It's about how the pathogen microbes interacting and how you characterizing them, and you can use it as a form of biocontrol, and you can also as a form of yield enhancement. So Dr. Miao actually way back is a pioneer in doing biocontrol, but they don't talk about microbiomes because at that time you look at one or two organisms at a time. Right now it's different because we will have sequencing capacity, and you actually look at all the tests in the microbial environment and all the way up to the plant. So I think the e-book allows us opportunity to accumulate those information when it's ready, post it to people, and then the community will see, will respond if they see useful information they put on. So get an effect that like snowball. So I think that we actually the e-book advantage is people can add information quite easily. So finally, I hope that I would say that possible next to the e-book, you should add the little corner, so for comments. Right? So if you see it's easy to upload, you see the you have a problem downloading, so we should know that, right? So information and so on, so we can actually. So then you keep it, the website very dynamic. So I think that's all I have to say about future. The future, we talk about 5 years. Okay, thank you.
Soon. Okay, thank you very much, Hei.